So this question asks us to create a nest in the center of the world about the origin of 9 patches, and we're going to color that nest orange. So let's go to the code, and first we'll add a new turtle variable. So the first line where it says turtles own, within the brackets, type in return to nest. Question mark. Then we'll create a new patch variable. So type in patches own, bracket, nest, question mark, close bracket. Now we need to add a couple lines to the setup procedure. So in the ask turtles command, let's set return to nest to be false. If we don't do this, netlogo will set any new variable to true by default. So now we'll add a new line, which will become a new procedure, and we'll call it setup nest. Now to add that procedure, begin with a 2, setup nest, and we'll ask patches, which puts us in the patch context, to set the variable nest to be true whenever a patch falls within a distance of 2 from the origin. So to write that, we'll use distance, the distance primitive, 0, 0, in parentheses, less than 2. And if a patch has that criteria, if nest is true, then set the pcolor to be orange. Close bracket. And always end a procedure with end. Let's see if that works. No closing bracket for this open bracket. So I forgot a bracket. I'll add that. Let's see if that does it. Looks like it's okay now, so we'll go to interface, press setup, and we can see that it's hard to tell that there's 9 patches here, but I'll assume that there is. Now there's an orange nest in the center of the world. Next, we're asked to write some code that will have the ants return to the nest after they eat food before they go out and forage again. There are many ways you could do this. The way that I'll do it is the following. First, I'd like to simplify the to-go procedure a little bit. So I'm going to create a new procedure, and I'm going to call that look for food. So I'll cut this section, write a new procedure line, and paste it. And now I'll go back to the go procedure and insert. So if else return to nest is false, then we'll look for food. And consequently, if return to nest is true, we will return to nest. We have not yet written this procedure, return to nest, so we'll do that next. Before we do that, however, it's a good idea to check the code to see if we've made any mistakes so far. So I'm going to press check, and there it's telling us that we do not have a return to nest procedure yet. But I also noticed that I forgot an equal sign after this line, so I'm going to insert that. And then we'll write the return to nest procedure. So for this, we'll just simply write face patch 0, 0, which is the origin, and go forward 1. And that will take any ant that has the return to nest variable true to face the origin and to take one step in that direction. And then we want to tell it to go forage again if it's at the nest. So if the pea color is orange, which means it's returned home, we will set return to nest false because it's already there. Whoops. Closing bracket. And so far we don't have any ants that have returned to nest set to be true. So obviously we need to do that. After they've eaten the food, let's set return to nest to be true. We'll check this code. Looks okay. Go back to the interface, set up, and then press go. And there are quite a few ants. It's hard to see what they're doing. So let's reduce the number of ants. Try it again. Slow it down some. You may be able to see that the ants are behaving like they should. They're eating food and returning to the nest before they venture out again. We could change the color back to red to make it more obvious, but let's save that for later.